I've been to many beautiful, green, scenic places, but the first time I came here, I knew it was special. There was a very different, deep feeling of inner peace. Hi everyone and welcome to Sugar Spice Nice. My name is Shweta and in this video, I'm giving you a tour of Paramahansa Yogananda's ashram in Ranchi. I'm inside the YSS or Yogda Satsang Society of India ashram and this is a place that I'd recommend to all. Whether you're living in Ranchi or just visiting the city, I'd recommend you to come once and just experience the bliss here. But let me tell you this, the feeling of peace and joy that one experiences here is not just because of the beauty of the surroundings, but it's because of all the effort of a spiritual person. Paramahansa Yogananda is known as the father of yoga in the West. But it was here in this very place that he founded an ashram and boys' school in the year 1917. And that led to the worldwide spread of Kriya Yoga teaching. Kriya Yoga is a spiritual science, a technique that was lost for centuries, an approach that is mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita by Bhagwan Shri Krishna. Patanjali also speaks about Kriya Yoga in the Yoga Sutras. After the Dark Ages, this path was reintroduced by Mahavatar Babaji in modern times and then passed on to his disciple Lahiri Mahashay and from him to Swami Sri Yukteswar Giri, who was the guru of Paramahansa Yogananda. Yoganandji was given the duty to spread the ancient science of Kriya Yoga across the world, and this ashram in Ranchi is where it all began. A lot of people visit the Yogda Satsang ashram to pay homage to their guru, Sri Paramahansa Yogananda, and attend YSS events. A lot of others just visit this place because it is so beautiful and enchanting. If this is your first time here, then let me show you a few places within the ashram that you must see. Come. This behind me is the main building, and this is a very, very special place within the ashram. It is the original building where Yoganandji started the organization. It now has a reception, bookstore, and Paramahansa Yogananda's room as well. While I can't take you inside Guruji's room, let me show you the window to the room. This is where Paramahansa Yogananda's room used to be, and now it has been preserved as a shrine. Devotees can go in, pay their respects, and even sit down and meditate for some time. There are also a few personally used items by Yoganandji which are here on display. There is also a fountain right opposite and of course a beautiful green garden. Right in the center of the ashram is the lychee tree. There's so many times that I find myself coming here and sitting under the branches of the tree. The calmness, the peace that I feel after sitting here for even a few minutes is something that I can't put in words. This is a sacred spot because Yoganandji used to give classes for the boys' school right under this tree. So many a times during his classes and while doing Sankirtan with the boys, Yoganandji would enter into Samadhi and remain in that state for hours. And because of that, the spot is hallowed by the spiritual vibrations of Paramahansaji. And recently, scientists have discovered a remarkable physical fact about this spiritually beloved tree. It has been scientifically recognized as a unique variety, never before documented by horticulturists, and is now officially named after Paramahansa Yogananda. The name is now listed as Lychee Cultivar Yogananda Selection. There is also the Smriti Mandir here, and readers of the autobiography of a yogi will know that it was in this very spot that Paramahansa Yogananji had a vision of going to America and spreading the teachings. In 1920, Paramahansa Yogananji was here in Ranchi and he was meditating in a storeroom behind some dusty boxes. And he had a vision, and that vision is so beautifully described in the autobiography of a yogi. And this Smriti Mandir is that same storeroom. It's so beautifully made into this mandir. If you are visiting the ashram, then I highly recommend coming here and spending a few minutes here to feel the calm that you've probably never ever felt before. Behind me is the Dhyan Mandir. Dhyan means meditation, and this is where all the daily meditations happen here. And there are different timings for meditation, morning and evening, and both of these are led by sannyasis or monks from the ashram itself. Apart from the meditation timings, one can go inside the Dhyan Mandir at any time. So right now I'm right in the middle of the ashram, and literally from this spot you can see the expanse completely. So behind me is the lychee tree, right there is the main building, and here is the Smriti Mandir, and over here is the Dhyan Mandir. Many people come to the ashram for different reasons. Some just come here to meditate, while some come here to enjoy the beauty all around. Recently, I attended a session in this ashram where a senior Swami from Biases beautifully explained concept of energy and pranayama and led the audience in a guided meditation session. I'll leave a link to that video in the description box. If you get a chance, then do watch it and follow the guided meditation. It will instantly put a lot of things in perspective and also give you a glimpse of that inner peace. All through the ashram, you'll see beautiful gardens with benches where you can actually sit down, interiorize and meditate. The ashram is open for anyone to visit, and on Sundays they actually have a meditation along with a satsanga followed by lunch prasad. I remember the first time I visited this ashram, it was in 2014, and after that I kept coming back here, and now it's been close to 2 years that I've been on the Kriya Yoga path, and it has truly changed me as a person and also changed my life for the better. Today scientists are stating that everything is energy. All objects and everyone is made of energy. Energy is distributed throughout the body, and when we use YSS meditation techniques to bring this energy back into the spine and brain, it activates our chakras and we experience higher states of consciousness. Peace, joy and health are all obtained through yoga. But realization of one's true purpose is the main objective of yoga. And to be able to think of oneself beyond just this body is something that a spiritual science like this helps us with. A book that I'd recommend reading is The Autobiography of a Yogi. It is a spiritual classic, a bestseller that has had a profound effect on millions and helped them navigate their spiritual search. I'll leave a link for the book in the description box below, along with the website link for YSS, where you can find out more information about them, write to them if you have any queries. While Yogita has various ashrams throughout the country and also many meditation centers, there's probably one in your city as well. The good thing about this path is that you don't actually physically have to go anywhere. They have a set of self-study lessons that are sent to you, and you can follow those lessons, understand the techniques and learn how to practice them as well. In fact, you have to sign up for these lessons, but I think there are 2 introductory lessons which are available for free to everybody, and I'm going to leave details about that in the description box below. If you get a chance, then do sign up for them, and you never know, maybe that is something that you have been secretly looking for. I had been wanting to share this place with you for a while, and I finally got an opportunity to do so, and I hope this tour has helped you guys. At least you can feel a little bit of that peace that I feel over here. And if you think this video is going to be helpful to any of your friends and family, then don't forget to share it with them and also hit that thumbs up if you like the video. And if you want to support my channel, then definitely subscribe to it, because I keep sharing more beautiful places on this channel. And that is it from me in this video. I'll see you in my next one. Jai Guru. Bye.